Hey guys, illusionist Jason Bishop. I am here with another piece of magic. In this case, it's a piece that I actually do in my show. Now, a little bit of backstory on this. I was, let me slow this thing down a little bit here. There we go. I was fortunate enough to have two successful runs in New York City on 42nd Street. And although it was one of the hardest things I've ever done professionally, it was absolutely one of the most rewarding things I've ever done in my life, period. When you're doing a show like that, you have to get new illusions and new magic, and you have to find new music. And when I listen to music, I listen to the lyrics. And this particular song was about somebody who was going through a challenging time in his life. He was trying to achieve a really, really big goal. People thought he was crazy, and even used the library to achieve this goal. And for magicians, especially myself anyway, the library was super important growing up. So it just kind of like really seemed totally apropos at the time that we were working on the show. So I kept listening to the song, but it didn't work for anything. So I held on to it, fast forward like 6 years later, and I'm working on this piece of magic, which is one of the newest pieces in the show. And the music just sort of fit for me. It's a difficult piece, and the song was about something difficult. So it just kind of married up pretty well. Now, this is a John Mayer song, and although some of you have heard of it, a lot of you have not, because it's not one of his big hits. It has kind of an unusual title. It's called Walt Grace's Submarine Test, January 1967.
Walt Grace, desperately aiding his old place, dreamed to discover a new space and buried himself alive inside his basement. Tongue on the side of his face, man. He's working away on displacement and what it would take to survive. 'Cause when you're done with this world, you know the next is up to you. And his wife told his kids he was crazy, and his friends said he'd fail if he tried. But with a will to work hard and a library card, he took a homemade fan blade, one man submarine ride. Mad, and I mean it. Waves as big as he'd seen it, deep in his dreams at home. From dry land, he rolled it over to wet sand, closed the hatch up with one hand, and paddled off alone. 'Cause when you're done with this world, for once in his life it was quiet, as he learned how to turn in the tide. And the sky was a flare when he came up for air in his homemade fan blade, one man submarine ride.
Difficult enough to build. They're not easy to build, but it's not magic, obviously. So we're going to take this to a whole other level.
Tokyo. 'Cause when you're done with this world, you know the next. as they speak of the man who took a homemade fan.